Okay, hopefully the last of the recording issues sorted out. We're going to do that simple example that I was about to get on to before it cut off. Thank God I checked. And that simple example, which should use those properties and give me a chance to teach you some exponents, because you didn't want to learn any, but now you're going to have to, is as follows. We have the log base 5. And as always, I encourage you to think about this on your own, but you won't be able to because you don't know exponents, because you wouldn't let me teach you them. Log base 5 of that. And I don't think you've seen that kind of symbol before. I know that you've seen this, and you know that that's asking you what number must I multiply by itself in order to obtain x. You know, that's just saying, okay, well, what, you know, how do I get here by squaring something? It's the square root. So, for example, to you, but to me, I see this and I say, what root is that? Because how do you know it's asking you for the square root? You don't just get to a number by squaring something. You could also cube something to get there. You could quadruple. You could take the quintile root, you could do infinity. There's infinite possibilities. So what's actually missing here is a y, right there. There should be a y here telling you how many times we want to multiply something by itself in order to get this number. What root is it, basically? So this is the y-th root of x. So this is asking for the cube root of 5. It's asking for, by the way, as an example, you know this one because you've done it many times. The cube root of 8. What number do you have to cube to get 8? You've seen this before. This is asking for the cube root of 5. I don't know what number you have to cube to get 5. I know it exists, but I'm not about to compute it. But there's a way around that. Because if you know your exponents, you know that this expression, the y root of x, is equal to x raised to 1 over y. It just is, because I told you so. So, if you see this, you can turn it into this. If you see this, you can turn it into this. And right now, we're seeing that. We have this ugly expression up here. I don't know what the cube root of 5 is. So, I'm going to turn that around and make that 5 to the 1/3. Then, I'm going to use my power rule to knock that exponent down. This is going to equal 1/3 times log base 5 of 5, which is just 1/3 times 1, as we know. And there's your answer. This evaluates to 1/3. Are we still recording? I don't trust it. We're still recording. Okay. So we can do the bigger problems now. Finally. All right. So what I'm going to have you do today, instead of solving these big log problems, I'm going to give you some complex logarithm statements, and I want you to use the rules that you've learned to condense them, make them smaller, make them simpler, make them more human readable. So, and they're going to get more complicated as they go on. The first couple aren't that bad. So yeah. Condense them, but don't solve them. First one. Now try that on your own. You should be able to identify the rules that you can use to sort this one out. As always, I encourage you to pause the video and do this yourself. You should be able to. What we'll do first is we'll do the reverse power rule. Right? Because this comes up here, and we know that x to the 1/2 is equal to the square root of x, because we just talked about that, plus log x plus 1 to the 3rd. do is use the product rule in reverse to say, well, this is just log square root of x times x plus 1 to the third. And there it is, simple. Air quote simple. Next example. Are we still recording? We are. 2 times the log of x plus 2 minus log x. Okay. Here, again, reverse product rule. And then reverse the quotient rule to bring this guy over here. So you're going to end up with log x plus 2 squared over log x. And that is the quantity of which you're taking the log. Right? It's not log x plus, it's not the logarithm over log x. It's in here. And that's good enough.